All right, ladies and gentlemen, we got another ACT prep question. All right, this one here deals with coordinate planes. I'd say it's probably going to be located in geometry, but let's get real. This is the kind of problem you'll see in algebra, geometry, and algebra 2, all up in those mugs, which, you know, the ACT is saturated with. Okay, here we go. In the standard XY coordinate plane below, three of the vertices of a rectangle are shown. Which of the following is the fourth vertex of the rectangle? All right, now, here's one of those problems you can't really work unless you have options like these right here, okay? The reasoning is because this rectangle, it could go, like that point could be down on this side, or it could be up here. It can be a lot of places. Actually, it can't. I lied. For it to be a rectangle, it's probably going to have to be right in this mug right here, right in this area right here. That's my guess. I got ahead of myself because I started thinking of parallelogram, which if it's a parallelogram, it could be here also. But then again, this isn't a right angle. And you can use the geometric, official geometric thing of TBL, which is tell by looking. Don't tell your teacher that. They'll hate it. But you can tell that wouldn't be a right angle right there. And then you know it can't be somewhere up in here or over here. Well, just because that wouldn't be a rectangle either. We know it's going to probably have to be in here. Now, I could be wrong. Probably not. But let's go ahead and try it out. First, let's look for one of these coordinates right here that would fall into that little area, okay? Let's see, 3, negative 7, 3, down 7, that could be a feasible one. So let's put that little blue dot, we might do it. Let's see, 4, negative 8, which would be 1, 2, 3, 4, going 1, 2, let's see, I'm showing you because in case you didn't know, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then down 8, I'm going to count down here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Could be that one. Looks a little low, but it could be that one. 5, negative 1, that'd be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, negative 1. Is that going to make a rectangle? No, that's dumb looking. 8, negative 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3. That would make a parallelogram, but I really don't think it. We'll put a maybe. I don't think that's going to be a rectangle. And then 9, negative 3, that's going to be even worse. It's going to be like right there. So I would say probably no on those two. My guess is F or G. All right, now, this is how you can, an easy way to figure it out. In a rectangle, okay, let's say we're just a straight-up rectangle. These sides are congruent, these sides are congruent, okay? One of the other real fancy things is these are all right angles, okay? Because if we just go off of the opposite sides being congruent, well, that's wonderful and handy-dandy. But what we need right here, that just means it could be a parallelogram. With the right angles right here, that makes it a rectangle, okay? Another fun fact, another quadrilateral that has all right angles is, that's right, a square, which I always say is like the Captain America of quadrilaterals because it has all the best, most unique parts of all the other quadrilaterals. Who cares? Okay. So here's our rectangle. If these are all right angles, what do we know about slopes when it comes to lines hitting at right angles with this line and this line? We know the slopes are going to be opposite reciprocal. So like if the slope of this line right here is 2 over 3, then what's perpendicular is going to be negative 3 over 2. Remember, you switch on the line and you switch the sign. All right. So like for instance, let's say you've got 4 over 7. Perpendicular to that would be negative 7 over 4. If it's negative 2 over 1, then it's going to be positive 1 over 2. See what I'm doing? Switching it over the line right here. And I was also switching the sign. Switch sign. Switch the line, okay? That's what you do if they're perpendicular. I think that's going to be our quickest route to solving this problem. All right, what I want to do is I'm going to find the slope of these two, and then I'll know it has to be parallel to the slope of these two, okay? And I think that's going to be able to narrow down our options. So we've got negative 1, negative 1, and 2, 1. So our x, always label because that's what you should do, x1, y1, x2, y2. Okay, our slope formula is y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. Okay, slope formula. Slurpy-derper. All right, now we just plug in our stuff. If you've labeled it well, you're good to go. So we'll start with our y2, which is right here, even though I made it look like an x. That's 1 minus our y1, which is negative 1, over our x2, which is 2 minus negative 1, okay? And then whenever you minus a negative, it turns into a positive, so that's 2 over, and that turns into a positive as well, 3. So that's our slope, 2 over 3, which I guess we should have counted. That was dumb. Could have just counted 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. That's just silly. Okay, well, I kind of messed up my graph, so I feel justified. All right, so what I need to do is I need to find another one right here that is the exact same. And you're thinking, well, you just told us to do opposite reciprocal up here. Well, that's if they're perpendicular. All right, what I was trying to tell you is with this right angle here, these two are perpendicular. So if this right here is 2 over 3, all right, that means this one has to be negative 3 over 2, right? But then again, this is perpendicular as well. Therefore, you would have to switch it back to 2 over 3. So essentially, these are the same. Now, if you remember from earlier lessons I've taught, if you have parallel lines, their slopes are going to be the exact same. So if 2 over 3 is parallel to 2 over 3, okay? Like negative 4 over 7 is parallel to negative 4 over 7. Okay? It's the exact same. Has to be the exact same. Can't be off at all. All right? Yes, you can reduce it to make it to where it's the reduced version, and that's the best way to find out if they're the same, because like 2 over 3 is the same as 4 over 6, but you wouldn't know that unless you reduced it down to 2 over 3. All right? So what we're looking for is another slope that is 2 over 3. So it has to match up with the 6 and the negative 5. So I guess we'll just start with this first one, okay? So that's our, this will be our x1, our y1, and then I'll make this our x2, y2. Okay, here we go. Our y2 is negative 7 minus, and our y1 is negative 5. Okay, and then I take my 3 minus my 6. It's negative 7 minus negative, that turns into a positive, so negative 7 plus 5 is negative 2. And then 3 minus 6 is negative 3. What happens when you have two negatives? They become a positive. Is that what we want? Do we want two-thirds? Do we want two-thirds? All day, yo. Hi, my name's Billy, and I'm happy for you that you solved your problem. Thanks, guys. Go ace that ACT. Boy, welcome to college.
Hey, Tyler here. Don't forget to subscribe. Check out tarveracademy.com.
All right. Check out the Facebook page, Tyler's Okay. That's facebook.com/Tyler's Okay. Check out the Twitter, my other YouTube channel. We also got a website. And then if you could, please subscribe to this channel. You know, it just means so much to me and all the children in all of the worlds.